I'd like to tell you a little bit about our video system and what makes it so much better than our competition. First, our body is actually molded out of lightweight carbon fiber. We have several molds to mold the exact size to fit your camera. This is our smallest system here. This is designed to fit a GoPro or a small hand cam, although we go all the way up to a full DSLR size video mounts. This one is a two-axis system. The basic features that are in our two-axis system are the digital servo drive, which allow the pan and tilt, as well as slipper clutches that allow the system to slip in case it's bumped or mishandled to prevent the servos and gears from stripping. Also, it incorporates a slip ring that gives it 360 degree rotation without any wires getting twisted up. Even though it's doing this, there is electrical communication between the upper and the lower half. The receiving unit is up here, as well as the stabilizer for the pan, while as the tilt stabilizer and servo driver down here. Also, the camera and the transmitter are down here to give an unobstructed view for the transmitting antenna. However, to keep the system light, the batteries are actually located up here. And this is all incorporated with the slip ring. Other features this has are limit switches that prevent you from damaging the servo. It simply shuts off the tilt when it gets to its endpoints. It has this in both the up and the down direction. Also, the video system incorporates a 5.8 gigahertz transmitter, which allows you to view the footage live on the ground. This is done with a ground-based receiver that you simply put in your pocket. The system here is lightweight, easy to keep in your pocket. And if you're going to fly the system at an extended range, you simply remove the antenna and plug in this antenna. You keep this on your chest and then you just point your body towards the blimp, and it has a much longer range. You can fly the blimp well beyond the standard 100 meters that the omnidirectional antenna provides. Also, while the aircraft is flying, you can view the footage live as you're manipulating the camera with these head-worn monitors. The head-worn monitors allow you to see the image clearly even in direct sunlight. While you're controlling the camera, the controls are very simple. It's a pan and tilt control here. Very instinctive controls. Also, the left stick is the zoom. When you push in, it zooms in. When you pull out, it zooms out. Also, this blimp is incorporated, the camera system has two stabilizers incorporated in it. One of them is a pan stabilizer, which you can see the action here as we rotate the blimp. You rotate the blimp, notice the camera stays at its original heading. Also, we have a tilt stabilizer. As we roll the blimp, let's go ahead and roll the blimp, you can see the camera stays at its original attitude. These two stabilizers, in conjunction with the standard stabilizing technology within the camera, provides for a very stable image. Also, the system is controlled with a 2.4 gigahertz spectrum radio system, which has very reliable performance, and it has a range of approximately 1 kilometer. So you will not lose control of the camera as long as the blimp is within range. And the system also incorporates two different power systems. One power system controls the servos, the panning and tilting mechanism, as well as the zoom. That power system is actually fed from the main power of the blimp, so it doesn't have a separate battery for that. But it does have a separate battery for the video transmitter. That allows the transmission to have a very clean voltage supply, so you do not get a fuzzy signal, a very clean signal. Both the power supply for the pan and tilt system, as well as the transmitter, have their independent switches here, so you can simply turn the controls or the camera or the transmitter on or off and fly the blimp without the camera turned off. Also, one last feature I'd like to mention. Sometimes you do not want the camera system to be stabilized. You want to point it forward with the blimp and leave it pointed forward, at which point you can shut the stabilizers off. Now, the camera simply stays locked in the heading relative to the blimp, without moving.